Welcome to a lesson in which we're given an interval using an inequality and then asked to graph the interval as well as express the interval using interval notation. So for our first example, the inequality is x is greater than positive 2. Notice how it does not say x is equal to positive 2, just greater than. And therefore, we have an open point on positive 2 to indicate that 2 is not in the interval. And then we have an arrow to the right where values get greater than positive 2. As we move to the right, we would approach positive infinity. And it's helpful to include this because it helps us write the interval using interval notation. Using interval notation, the interval is from 2 to infinity. It does not include positive 2, so we say the interval is open on positive 2, and we use a rounded parenthesis instead of a square bracket. And then for infinity and negative infinity, we always use a rounded parenthesis. It's also important to recognize that the order of these is important. The 2 has to come first and the infinity has to come second in the same order it would occur on the number line. Now looking at the second example, notice how we have x is less than or equal to positive 2. So because of the equal part of this, 2 is included in the interval, and therefore we make a closed point on positive 2. But x is also less than 2, so we have an arrow to the left where values get smaller than positive 2, we would approach negative infinity. So here's the graph of the interval, and then using interval notation, we have negative infinity to positive 2, but because it includes positive 2, we use a square bracket here, and as always for negative infinity, a rounded parenthesis. Now let's take a look at two compound inequalities. Here we have negative 3 is less than or equal to x, and x is less than 4. So notice how the interval is between negative 3 and positive 4, where it does include negative 3, but it does not include positive 4. So we start at negative 3 with a closed point because it includes negative 3, and then it moves to the right until we reach positive 4. And it does not include positive 4, so we'll make an open point here. It might also be helpful to think of this as two inequalities connected with and, meaning if we start in the middle with x, we can read this from right to left as well as from left to right. We can also write this as x is greater than or equal to negative 3. Notice how the inequality is still open toward the x. And x is less than 4. These two mean the same thing, just written a different way. And then using interval notation, the interval is from negative 3 to positive 4. It includes negative 3, so we have a square bracket. It does not include positive 4, so we have a rounded parenthesis. So we say the interval is closed on negative 3 and open on 4. Next, we have x is less than or equal to negative 3, or x is greater than 4. So notice how the first interval does include negative 3, so we have a closed point. And x is less than or equal to negative 3, so we have the interval to the left approaching negative infinity. Or we have x is greater than positive 4. This interval does not include 4, so we have an open point here. And because it's greater than 4, the interval is to the right, approaching positive infinity. So because we have two intervals, we'll have two intervals using interval notation. The interval on the left, we would have negative infinity to negative 3, rounded parenthesis on negative infinity, square bracket on negative 3 because it includes negative 3. And then we can say or we can also use u for union. And then we have the interval from 4 to infinity, rounded parenthesis on 4 as well as infinity. It's rounded on 4 because 4 is not included in this interval. Okay, that's going to do it for these examples. I hope you found this helpful.